Lower.
Exactly.
Lower. And let go.
The activity is called Toxic Waste. The team has to successfully transport the tennis ball of the toxic waste to the toxic waste facility. The entire team is blindfolded except for one person. That one person is the only one that's allowed to communicate.
To the right.
We've decided to take resiliency training out of the classroom environment and go ahead and operationalize it with some events like the confidence course, obstacle course, paintball lane, and we went ahead and charged our MRTs with developing this concept.
The benefits of having resiliency program established in the battalion is it supports the soldier at the lowest level. It allows the soldier to understand their skills out there for him to communicate better with his chain of command and through being an assertive communicator. That's one of the key ones, one of the key skills in resiliency training.
The way you look at a situation, whether you look at it as a threat or a challenge, whether you look at it as something that you can overcome, it makes a difference in your ability to be successful in that moment. So you might see this obstacle as insurmountable or frustrating, but that's not helpful for your performance. So if you're able to change the way you look at the situation, look at it more effectively, you can then attack that obstacle a lot more efficiently.
The skills that we're incorporating into it are real-time resiliency, and we touched a little bit on put in perspective. The skill of real-time resiliency basically allows a soldier or an individual to overcome counterproductive thoughts in real time. It allows them to overcome it immediately if used properly. In order to do this, we generally use 3-sentence starters. The first one being optimism.
Even though I might be having trouble, I'm still gonna make it.
The second, using evidence of past events, stuff we've already done. And the third one is putting in perspective, actually knowing what the consequences can be.
The scariest thing in my life.
To actually use the skills we're teaching and get that practice as soon as we teach it.
The capability of responding positive to these challenges will enable soldiers to complete their mission and ensure their families remain ready to provide the necessary support needed.